So I biked up to the mountains. Really wanted to check out this place called Kurullangala. Ancient 5,000 year old cave paintings. Thought I'd try to find it on my own, but I realized quickly after talking to local people, they're like, no, you're going through the jungle. So I found these guys.
Isuru?
Yeah. Sanduran.
Some local gents who are hopefully gonna guide me safely up here. Apparently it's treacherous. Let's see. My old age, I just need somebody to carry me.
This old man, he played one. He played knick-knack on my thumb.
Almost reached out and grabbed this. Yeah, these things will go right through your hand. Well, this is the jungle. This jungle has elephants and cobras and peacocks.
In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight. In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps too. I can't hear you, buddy. Bum bum, bum bum.
You sure that's tight?
Yep.
All right, well. Good thing the school's got good insurance on me.
Call or click to get a quote today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Got some leeches on my foot. Check it out. Yeah. Hold on. There we go, yeah. You know, in the olden days, doctors put leeches on your body when you're sick to suck the poison out of you. So maybe by the time I'm done this trek, I'll be cleaner than when I started. So there's a reason no one else in the town wanted to take me up here today. Except for these crazy guys. Yeah. Which is good, because
it'd be nice.
We're all crazy together. Never try this at home, children.
Ants go marching three by three, hoorah, hoorah. The ants go marching three by three, hoorah, hoorah. The ants go marching three by three. The little one stops to climb a tree and they all go.
I don't think I ever would have found this myself. I would have died. Natural rope. Let's do it. Woo! Oh. So this is what all the fuss is about. Right here. These rock drawings. These were discovered sometime in the 80s. Certainly people around the community knew that I was here for a while. They date it back over 5,000 years, but they didn't disclose the information of where it was. And then some researchers came, found it. And I think people started to explore it somewhere around 2015. As you can see, it's a bit of a complicated journey to get here. What's neat about this is that the paintings are very similar to the Aborigines in Australia. And these paintings, this kind of style is not found anywhere else in Sri Lanka. I mean, Australia isn't that far away, comparatively speaking, from, say, like Thunder Bay. I wonder if the Aborigines came here a long time ago and made this. What do you guys think? This is a bird of some kind. What's also interesting is there's nothing like familiar like cobras and elephants. Creatures and animals that are usually found on caves and rocks in Sri Lanka. It's totally different with these birds that don't actually exist or haven't maybe existed for a long time.
Much like today's birds, pterosaurs ruled Earth's Mesozoic skies, adapting to many different habitats while their dinosaur cousins roamed below. But these were no birds. Pterosaurs were flying reptiles, and some were as big as fighter jets.
Another interesting fact about this is that this faces east, where the sun rises, but it's lasted for over 5,000 years in direct sunlight. That is impressive. There's really no evidence or research at all to say exactly how old these paintings are, or exactly who did them, or why. I think it was the aliens, man.
I'm feeling like a nerd.